Today, I want to introduce you to Tally, the easiest way to create forms online, and it's free. Its intuitive interface allows you to quickly create forms without needing any technical skills. Forms in Tally can be highly customized to meet your specific needs, whether it's a registration form, survey, quiz, or job application. Best of all, everything I show you in this video is free to use. Let's take a look. Create a free account or jump right in and begin building a form on the website without signing in. Note that you will need to create a free account before you can publish your completed form. I am going to begin by looking at templates Tally has available. These templates are free to use and new ones are added regularly. All templates are fully customizable, and using one is a great way to quickly get started. I'm searching for a registration form template. I'm going to select this one and begin to customize for my conference needs. The registration form template begins by asking for general information about the attendee. If the template has a field that you don't need, you could select the trash icon to delete it. You can also drag the fields around to change the look and feel of the form. By clicking on the six dots next to a line, you can make additional edits, such as making the field a required one, or requiring a minimum or maximum number of characters. In addition to the questions that are already on the registration form template, I want to add some of my own. The first is going to be whether or not the conference attendee needs a hotel room. To do that, I'll select the plus button above where I want this new text block to appear. You see, Tally has a whole bunch of different inserts that you can add to the page easily. In this case, I want to add a question. The question is going to be whether or not they need a hotel room, and the answer options will be yes and no. So first, I'll type the question. Option one will be yes, and option two will be no. That's all you need to do. My next question is going to be what the desired dates of the hotel stay will be. So again, I'll repeat this process by selecting the plus button. And the question here will be a question plus date input. First, I'll type out my question. You'll see that it already added one date field, but since I want an arrival as well as a departure date, I'm going to select the plus button and add an additional date box. I'm then going to move that up here just for stylistic purposes. And then I can add placeholder text for arrival and departure. One of my favorite features of Tally is the ability to add conditional logic without the need for any coding. In this case, I'm going to add conditional logic to "Do you need a hotel room?" I'll select this icon and then add conditional logic. In this case, I don't want someone registering for the conference to get confused if they select that no, they do not need a hotel room. I want them to just jump to the payment section and not see the desired dates of stay. This can work really well if you have lots of different blocks in your form. So here I'll say, do you need a hotel room? If the answer is no, then I want to hide specific blocks. In this case, I want to hide, what are your desired dates of stay? As well as the arrival and departure date block. And that's all I need to do. When we preview this form shortly, you'll be able to see how that conditional logic works. Next, I want the ability to collect payment from conference attendees. I'm going to first add a headline here so that people know that it's the payment section. And I'll simply add payment. Then, in order to collect payment, all I need to do is select payment. Tally integrates with Stripe, which is an online payment processing system. So you will need to create a free Stripe account to use this feature. All I need to do is enter the value amount that I am requesting, and that's it. I connect with Stripe, and Tally takes care of the rest. Before publishing this form, I want to add some additional design customization to make it pop. Scrolling back to the top of the page, I can first add a cover design. I'm going to upload an image that I have already created for this conference that is on my computer. Once you open the file, Tally will upload it, and then you can reposition the cover photo so that it appears exactly how you want it to. Once that's done, click Save, and now I'm going to add a logo. Again, I'm uploading this directly from my computer, which makes it really easy to customize. And there we go. The last thing that I want to do is to confirm whether or not I have a thank you page. This is what the user would see once they click on the register button. And this is optional. You can turn this off if you don't want them to see an additional page. This part is customizable as well. And while you can't ask additional questions to gather information, you can customize the text. Before we publish this form, let's take a look at the preview, just to make sure it's exactly how we want it. We have all of the personal details and work information. Let's quickly see if the conditional logic worked. Do you need a hotel room? I'm going to select no. Perfect, it brought me directly to payment, and I connected it securely with Stripe, so everything works as it should. I'm going to go back to the editor, and now I'm ready to publish the form. Once you've clicked on publish, you'll receive a link to your form that can be shared. You can also embed your form on your own website. All forms created in Tally are responsive, meaning that they are optimized for use on various devices, including desktops, tablets, and smartphones, with no extra work required on your end. Tally keeps track of all submissions, and there's no limits to the amount of submissions you can receive. All of that information is tracked here in your Tally dashboard. You can also take advantage of some of the free integration options that Tally has available, like having your form submissions sent to Google Sheets or Notion, even Excel. Using a template is a quick and easy way to get started and create a form within minutes. But depending on your specific needs, you may want to create a form from scratch. In this scenario, I'm going to go back to my workspace and create a new form. In this scenario, I want to create a job application for my small business, which may seem like a daunting task, but it's really not when you're using Tally. You simply click anywhere into the page, and you have two options to start putting the fields into your form. One is clicking on the plus sign like we did in the previous example. When you're first getting started with Tally, this is what I recommend because it's a little easier to navigate all the different options. But as you're getting used to the different layouts available to you, you can simply use the /key to create new blocks. Here, I want to first put in personal contact information, so I can type in my placeholder text. Then click Enter. And I could put in another block. Here, I can look for phone number. And remember, for each one of these fields, you can select whether or not it's a required field or not. Last but not least, I'm going to go ahead and ask for an email address. And then I want to make sure that I have the ability for someone to attach a cover letter and resume. So let's take a look and see what's available to me. This is what's really clever about this program, is I could click on File Upload. And here, someone can upload a file directly from their computer, and it will be in my dashboard on Tally, so I can easily download it and also keep a running list of all of the people who have applied for my job. Above here, I want to add a text block so that people know exactly what it is that I'm asking them to upload. So I'll insert a text block and put in, please attach cover letter. And then below here, I'll go ahead and add another text box. There we go.
I can add additional details at the top of the page in text blocks. And I can also choose to add a logo, a cover, or change the design of my form. In this case, I just want to slightly alter the background color. And there we go. Let's preview our new design. Within minutes, you have a custom job application that you can publish on your site, completely free, no coding required. This can work so well for so many things, like camping trips, scouts, school activities, anything where you need to get data collection, file uploads, payment options. There's so many uses. Let's take one last look at some of the settings available to you. Under settings, there are additional features, such as adjusting the language settings, the ability to redirect users to a custom URL when they submit a form. You can add a progress bar for longer forms, quizzes, surveys. And you can also adjust the type of email notifications that you receive for new submissions. You can adjust the access to the form by closing the form or scheduling a date in advance to close the form, as well as limiting the number of submissions. Everything I showed you in today's tutorial is free to use, and 99% of Tally's features are free to use without limits. Tally does offer a pro subscription for teams and creators with more advanced needs, and you can find all of that information on their website. Tally is an efficient and versatile tool for form creation, from simple surveys to complex data collections. With their easy-to-navigate interface and highly customizable options, it helps both individuals and businesses get work done quickly. And it's free to use. Give it a try and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more helpful content.